Segmentation-based colorization. In segmentation-based colorization, i.e., local coloring, method, multispectral night vision imagery is rendered segment by segment with the statistical color properties of natural scenes by using the color mapping technique. Eventually, the colorized images resemble daylight pictures. The main steps of segmentation-based colorization are given below. 1. A false color image, source image, is first formed by assigning multispectral, 2 or 3 band, images to 3 RGB channels. The false colored images usually have an unnatural color appearance. 2. Then, the false colored image is segmented using the features of color properties, the techniques of nonlinear diffusion, clustering, and region merging. A set of clusters are formed by analyzing the histograms of the three components of the diffused image in L alpha beta color space. Those clusters are merged to segments if their similarity values in L alpha beta space are greater than a preset threshold. 3. The averaged mean, standard deviation, and histogram of a large sample of natural color images are used as the target color properties for each color scheme. The target color schemes are grouped by their contents and colors such as plants, mountain, roads, sky, water, buildings, people, etc. 4. The association between the source region segments and target color schemes is carried out automatically utilizing a classification algorithm such as the nearest neighbor paradigm. 5. The color mapping procedures, statistic matching and histogram matching, are carried out to render natural colors onto the false colored image segment by segment. 6. The mapped image is then transformed back to the RGB space. 7. Finally, the mapped image is transformed into HSVAL, hue saturation value, space, and the value component of the mapped image is replaced with the fused NV image, a grayscale image. Note that this fused image replacement is necessary to allow the colorized image to have a proper and consistent contrast. In this subsection, the RGB to LMS long wave, medium wave, and short wave transform is discussed first. Then, an L alpha beta space is introduced from which the resulting data representation is compact and symmetrical, and provides a higher decorrelation than the second order. The reason for the color space transform is to decorrelate three color components, i.e., L, alpha, and beta, so that the manipulation, such as statistic matching and histogram matching, on each color component can be performed independently. Inverse transforms, L alpha beta space to the LM sand LM sto RGB, are needed to complete the proposed segmentation-based colorization, which are given elsewhere, Zhang and Essock, 2008. The actual conversion, matrix, from RGB tristimulus to device-independent XYZ tristimulus values depends on the characteristics of the display being used. Fairchild, 1998, suggested a general device-independent conversion, while non-priori knowledge about the display device, that maps white in the chromaticity diagram to white in the RGB space and vice versa. The XYZ values can be converted to the LM space using the following equation. A logarithmic transform is employed here to reduce the data skew that existed in the above color space. Ruderman et al. 1998, presented a color space, named L alpha beta, luminance alpha beta, which can decorrelate the three axes in the LM space. The three axes can be considered as an achromatic direction, L, a yellow-blue opponent direction, alpha, and a red-green opponent direction, beta. The L alpha beta space has the characteristics of compact, symmetrical, and decorrelation, which highly facilitate the subsequent process of color mapping, see section 3.4. The nonlinear diffusion procedure has proven to be equivalent to an adaptive smoothing process, Barash and Komen issue, 2004. The diffusion is applied to the false colored NV image here to obtain a smooth image, which significantly facilitates the subsequent segmentation process. The clustering process is performed separately on each color component in the L alpha beta color space to form a set of clusters. The region merging process is used to merge the fragmental clusters into meaningful segments, based on a similarity metric defined in 3D L alpha beta color space, that will be used for the color mapping process. Nonlinear diffusion methods have been proven as powerful methods in the denoising and smoothing of image intensities while retaining and enhancing edges. Barash and Komen issue, 2004, have proven that nonlinear diffusion is equivalent to adaptive smoothing and bilateral filtering is obtained from an extended nonlinear diffusion. Nonlinear diffusion filtering was first introduced by Perona and Malik, 1990. Basically, diffusion is a parade, partial differential equation, method that involves two operators, smoothing and gradient, in 2D image space. The diffusion process smooths the regions with lower gradients and stops the smoothing at region boundaries with higher gradients. Nonlinear diffusion means the smoothing operation depends on the region gradient distribution. For color image diffusion, three RGB components of a false colored NV image are filtered separately, one by one. The number of colors in the diffused image will be significantly reduced and will benefit the subsequent image segmentation procedures, clustering and merging. The diffused false colored image is transformed into the L alpha beta color space. Each component, L, alpha or beta, of the diffused image is clustered in the L alpha beta space by individually analyzing its histogram. Specifically, for each intensity component, image, L, alpha or beta, I, normalize the intensity onto 2, bend the normalized intensity to a certain number of levels and then and perform the histogram analysis. 3, with a histogram, locate local extreme values, i.e., peaks and valleys, and form a stepwise mapping function using the peaks and valleys. 4, complete the clustering utilizing the stepwise mapping function. The local extremes, peaks or valleys, are easily located by examining the crossover points of the first derivatives of histograms. Furthermore, peaks and valleys are expected to be interleaved, for example, valley peak valley. Peak valley, otherwise, a new valley value can be calculated with a midpoint of two neighboring peaks. In addition, two end boundaries are considered two special valleys. In summary, all intensities between two valleys in a histogram are squeezed in their peak intensity and the two end points in the histogram are treated as valleys, rather than peaks. If there are peaks in a histogram, then an n-step mapping function is formed. If there are two or more valley values, including the special valley at the left end, at the left side of the leftmost peak, then use the special, extreme, valley intensity. Clustering is done by separately analyzing three components, L, alpha and beta, of the false colored image, which may result in inconsistent clusters in the sense of colors. Region merging is necessary to incorporate the fragmental clusters into meaningful segments in the sense of colors, which will improve the color consistency in a colorized image. If two clusters are similar, i.e., QWX, Y, greater than TQ, a predefined threshold, these two clusters will be merged. QWX, Y, is a similarity metric between two clusters, Zond Y, which is defined in the L alpha beta color space as follows. Where WK is a given weight for each color component. QKX, Y, is formulated as 7B. Where X macron and sigma X are the mean and the standard deviation of clusters in a particular component, respectively. Similar definitions are applied to cluster Y. The sizes, i.e., areas, of two clusters, Zond Y, are usually unequal. Notice that QKX, Y, is computed with regard to the diffused false color image. A nearest neighbor NN paradigm, Keysers et al., 2002, is demonstrated to classify the segments obtained from the preceding procedure, described in section 3.2. To use the NN algorithm, a distance measure between two segments is needed. The similarity metric QWX, Y, as defined in 7, between two segments, Zond Y, is used as the distance measure. Thus, the closer two segments in L alpha beta space, the larger their similarity. Similar to a training process, a lookup table, LUT, has to be built under supervision to classify a given segment, SJ, into a known color group, C, i.e., C equals TSJ, I less than or equal to J, where SJ is a feature vector that distinguishingly describes each segment, C stands for a known color scheme, for example, sky, clouds, plants, water, ground, roads, etc., and TIS a classification function, i.e., a trained classifier. We use segment color statistics, for example, mean and deviation of each channel, as features, of six statistical variables. The statistical features, SJ, are computed using the diffused false color images and the color mapping process is carried out between a false color segment and a daylight color scheme. The reason for using the diffused false color images here is because the diffused images are less sensitive to noise. In a training stage, a set of multispectral NV images are analyzed and segmented such that a sequence of feature vectors, SJ, can be computed and the LUT, mapping, between, SJ, and, C, can be manually set up upon the experimental results. In a classifying, testing, stage, all QWXK, SJ, values, for J equals 1, 2, 3, are calculated, where XK means the current classified segment and SJ represents one of the existing segments from the training stage.